Yo, welcome to Sam's Show, where the goal of this show is to educate and provide value where we can. So many of you guys don't know that 20% of things that we do are things that we really want to do. And then the other 8% are things that we actually been forced to do or doing for other people who are called manipulators. Yeah. So today I want to tell you guys first thing, how to know if you've been manipulated or how to know a manipulator. The first and obvious point of a manipulator, and this is I think young girls fall for this all the time, and girls really fall for this, and probably some guys, some naive guys, but if their actions don't match their words, this is both in relationships and both in business and even friendship, because many guys are used to promising the world. A guy promises you ponies but deliver donkeys. So that's how you know someone is manipulating you. Every time they are telling you they'll do this for you, this and that, but they don't actually do it consistently. Not because all of us do that thing. Sometimes we actually get caught up with some things. But if it's consistent every time, the person is always, and they're always bringing up something else. They haven't done the previous one, but they'll give us something else. Just know that this person is up to something, man. Second point is that manipulators are so good with reading you. So the first thing they do is learn your weaknesses. So how to know you've been manipulated is that they're always using your weaknesses against you. So they're always trying to tell you you're dumb, you're stupid, just things that will make you low and them higher. So they're always looking for a way of superiority. So the best way they can do it is bring you down. So they're going to pinpoint some of your weaknesses. Even if your strength dominates your weaknesses and you've improved so much, if maybe you know that you've improved so much, then they'll always use the tiny bit, the parts, like some small parts of weaknesses of, so they try making you feel like you're weak, you're stupid, you're nini. They'll use words like that, and you wouldn't know that. You just think, because mostly they'll say it when they're joking, and when you confront them about it, they'll actually pretend like they're joking about it. So that's how, and actually a huge way to learn about manipulators. If you decide to stand for yourself against a manipulator, they'll always try to make you feel guilty. If you decide to say maybe a no, or you're not following the rules of the manipulator, they always have this thing of making you feel guilty about it. So the best way to know about it is that they're always trying to use things like, you know, I've done this for you, so they'll use that against you. So they'll always, even if they've done something small, they'll always use that against you. You know, you guys have done this, so you, blah, 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 blah. There's a guy called Charles Manson, yeah? This guy was a guy for sex trafficking, man. So him used to use manipulation at the tops. You guys just need to search about this guy. This guy used to have this thing of telling these stories that he'll die for them, he'll do nini. So they always felt, one girl was being interviewed and she said that they always felt like they owe something to him. So that's how manipulators work. They always make you feel like you always owe them something, you get? So anything, even if you go against them or say no, so they'll always have this thing of making you feel guilty about what you said. So this guilty part also goes together with number four, whereby they're always looking at, like, the victim. This is especially when you find, I think the worst case is normally, especially if you find one who has like a mental health issue, because many, they'd use that against you, yeah? So many of them like to play as a victim. So what they do, this is what they do. So you'd ask them why you didn't, maybe you'd confront them why they didn't do whatever they did. You are courageous enough to confront them, yeah? And then you find out that this person, what they'll tell you, when you find out, when you ask them, yeah, yo, why didn't you do this and that? Why did you lie to me? Blah, blah, blah. They always have this thing of telling you, yeah, you know me, I was like, let's say if they were supposed to do something, they're like, yo, you know me, I'm going through so much stress. I'm going through so much right now. If you're me right now, you wouldn't even ask me this question. They'd find a way like to make you just feel guilty about it. It's not something for once in a while. It's something that they do most oftenly. So if you see that the person is using it so much, like they're always using that excuse, like always using this and that, when you actually now try confronting them about it, they're actually trying to, they have some manipulative ways to control you, yeah. And then of course many guys, also many of them go crazy sometimes, man. So another way to know is that when they're going crazy on you, man. Because many nice people, what they do when someone is acting all aggressive and crazy at you, you give them what they want so that they can actually chill down. So they're always like skipping. If they've gotten whatever they want from this person, boom, boom, ciao, you know. And that's so yeah, so that's what they do. So anyway, I hope this video helps. So if you guys want me to do on how you can actually play their game and how to stop manipulators, comment below and tell me. So yeah, so if you like this video also, chop it a like and subscribe. I release videos just like this every week. You know what? It's always keep it sunny, smiley, man. Cheers, man. I'm out. Boom. I said I'm out, my guys, man. I'm out. Anyway. I'm out, man, forever.